Hello guys, welcome back to another video. With the official release of Unreal Engine 5.6, the MetaHuman Creator has now been integrated directly into the engine. So in this video, I will show you how to create your own custom MetaHuman using the new Unreal Engine 5.6 MetaHuman Creator in engine. And if you are new here to the channel, my name is Smart Poly. I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and tutorials, so don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe. And without further ado, let's get right into the video. So in order to access the new MetaHuman Creator plugin, what you need to do is first, you need to download and install Unreal Engine 5.6. And when you're downloading and installing Unreal Engine 5.6, you want to come over here to the options. So click on the options and you want to make sure that you include this MetaHuman Creator core data right over here, which is 5.5 gigabytes. So hit the little checkbox and click apply. And if you forgot to include it in the download, you just come back over to your launcher version, go under the options and go ahead and hit that checkbox, and it will go ahead and download the MetaHuman core data. Then just create a brand new project in Unreal Engine 5.6. And once you've created your brand new project, in order to access the MetaHuman Creator plugin, we'll first need to go to your edit plugins and search for MetaHuman. And you'll need to go ahead and enable the MetaHuman Creator plugin right over here. Go ahead and enable that and restart your project. And once you've restarted your project, you should be able to right click, and under the MetaHuman tab in the content browser, you can add in a new MetaHuman character. And so that will add a brand new character that we can customize. And so you double click and open this up, and this will actually bring us to the new MetaHuman Creator editor. So let's go ahead and dock this window up here at the top. So in the center of our screen, we have our MetaHuman and the viewport. So you have your standard viewport controls, the middle mouse button to zoom in and out, left mouse button to rotate around. Then over here on the left, we have the different bars. So first we're going to start with the presets. So in 5.6, there are a bunch of new MetaHuman presets. So just have to double click on a preset to preview it. So if we click on this camera and preset, you can see that this MetaHuman is absolutely detailed. And there's a lot of new realistic presets that allow for some more unique and diverse MetaHumans that were previously not available in the previous version of the MetaHuman Creator. So yeah, the detail is absolutely insane. So with the Creator, you can also create your own custom MetaHuman. So if you head over to the body over here, you can go ahead and start modifying this preset. So you can see we have a couple of different things we can change on the body itself. So for example, you can go ahead and mix and match. So if we take, you know, one of the different characters over here and just mix and match, we should be able to, you know, tweak the MetaHuman size based on the different blend presets that we have here enabled. But another neat feature in 5.6 is that you can head over to this model section and you can actually adjust some of the global parameters, such as muscle mass. So you can adjust how much actual muscle mass the character has, so you can make him super, you know, ripped, or you can make him super skinny like that. And you can actually input some real world values. So if you have your actual height, you can input that in here. You'd also adjust things like the fat, and also that adjusts the actual values like the shoulder, the chest, the waist, the hip. So you can go in and adjust each of these single values and tweak precisely what you want. So if you want the chest to be a little bit smaller, you can go ahead and adjust the actual values. Okay, so you can adjust other things like the neck, the arms, the legs. But other than that, we can switch over to the head. So with the head, you can go ahead and blend different shapes. So you can drag in different presets and blend between the three different shapes. So as you can see, you can change and adjust different parts of the face. Other than that, we can head over to the materials tab and we can adjust things like adding freckles to the face. We can also change different regions to add, you know, redness in the skin or saturation or even lightness. And under the eyes, you can change the different eye colors. They have a lot, including the iris, to actually customize in here, along with makeup as well. So you could add in things like eyeliner and highlights, and of course, things like lipstick. Under the teeth and eyelashes, we also have some more different settings. So you can choose different eyelash and teeth color. Then finally, we have the hair and clothing settings, so you can choose from the new hair presets, and there's quite a bit of new hair presets compared to what they previously had. So just double click and load the groom asset. And also we have things like eyebrows, facial hair, so we have mustaches, we also have beards. So let's just go ahead and add a beard on this guy. Okay, and then we have the default clothing garment, which you can actually download more different ones on the marketplace. But once you have your character all finished over here, you want to go over to the assemble tab. And before we actually assembled, it's going to say character is not rigged. So you want to go ahead and create a full rig. So go ahead and click create a full rig. That will go ahead and run the auto rigging and rig up the character. Okay, and then it's going to say we need to download the missing textures. So under the download texture source, you can select from downloading 2K resolution textures to 4K up to 8K. So I'm going to download 2K resolution, and those will go ahead and download those textures. Now, once we're finished, you can go ahead and re-click on the assemble button, and you should see this green assemble button, which means that we can now export it. But we also have a couple of export settings, so you can choose from the cinematic if you want the complete detailed MetaHuman, or you can use the optimized version, or for UEFN. Or if you're exporting this to a third-party DCC, for example, you know, Maya or Blender, which now is allowed with the new MetaHuman licensing, you'll go ahead and select the DCC export. So I'm just going to click Cinematic for UE and click Assemble, and that will go ahead and export the character into our content browser. Okay, so just finished exporting. So now if you head over to your folder over here, you should see a new folder for MetaHumans, and under that folder, we have the new MetaHuman character. So here is the blueprint, so we can go ahead and drag this guy into our level. And as you can see, we have our new MetaHuman character downloaded. And this is with the 2K resolution textures. So you can download much higher resolution textures. But once you have him in your scene, you can go ahead and animate him by just going and creating a new level sequence. And then just selecting him and dragging him from the outliner into the sequencer. And that will go ahead and pop in and spawn the control rig, so you can start going and keyframing and animating your character in the engine. So that is the brand new MetaHuman creator inside of Unreal Engine 5.6. I'd like to hear you guys' thoughts on this down in the comments down below. Is this something that you'd use in your future projects? Let me know down in the comments. And that's pretty much it for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.